Hello, this is Vivek and welcome to PHP Forms for Developers series. In this video, we are going to work on displaying errors and success messages in PHP. Previously, I have added PHP validations. Here you can see all these messages after submitting the form with empty values. We are getting all these messages back, but these are simple echo messages and we should be use an array or a variables to display these messages, and we'll see in which case we are going to use this arrays or variables. If you want to display the message, error message, after the input field, every input field, or before every input field, for that we'll use variables. Let's see how we can do that. I'm adding this message to fname error. It's a variable. And lname error. I have added these two variables, fname error and lname error. Let's go to these input fields. Here, these are the input fields. I am going to add an PHP block. If is set fname error and not empty, fname error echo fname error. That's it. And same for this last name field also. Here this variable will change lname error. What I'm doing here is I'm assigning this error message variables instead of echo PHP function. I'm assigning these two variables, so we can use these variables here after this input fields or before this input fields. That's your wish. However you want to use or you want to display, you can use them. Here I'm checking if it's a set and not empty. If this variable is set and not empty, both these conditions I am checking in this if block. If it set and not empty, then I'm going to display this first name field's error variable. And same for the last name field. Let's check it in browser. Submit. First name field is required and the last name field is required. Instead of displaying this error message here, I'm displaying the error message right after this input fields, and we should add a styling. For that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a bootstrap classes for this error fields. Previously, here I'm using bootstrap for this form styling, so we can use bootstrap classes for adding error message styling for this. And inside this echo message, I hope you already know about a string concatenation. Here I'm going to use a string concatenation for adding this styling. Okay, first block is concatenated. Here I'm going to add a span class, and we are in double quotes, so I'm going to use single quotes for this class. I'm going to add alert class and alert danger. And I'm going to close this span class here by concatenating again. That is a string concatenation, span. Saving this file, let's go to browser and see how it's displaying. Submit. Okay, it's not working for span. Let's change this to P. That is a paragraph tag. Okay, now it should work. It's working, but we are not able to see this message. I have an error. Okay, that's okay. Here I haven't closed this. That's the issue. Let's submit this form again. Here you can see this error message, and we can add a break tag or other CSS styling to add the gap. Let's add a break tag here before this. Only if this error is displaying, I am going to add a break tag. so that we can have the gap between these two. These two, that is input field and the error. Now you can see. So you learned how you can display individual errors right after these input fields by just assigning them to variables. I'm going to add this to last name also after echo, and this string concatenation also we should use after the variable last name error variable. I'm going to reload this page and submit the form. First name field is required, last name field is required, and same for email, gender and age. All these you just have to add these variables here. I'll explain you how you can do that. You have to add these variables here: email error, gender error and age error. Just use this block, copy this block, paste it here, and change the variables. Paste it here and change the variables. Paste this block here, paste a block here, that's a PHP block, and change the variables. That's it. Here also same, here also same. I hope you understand how to display these individual errors, and let's see how you can display these errors here. For that I am going to use array for displaying errors, and I am going to call it as errors array. This is a format, and we'll use a for each loop. I am assigning all these errors to errors array. Okay, that's done. And removing this PHP block. These two PHP blocks, it's not required. I'm removing them. And here I'm going to add inside a panel body, or after this H3 panel heading tag, I'm going to add this error message inside a for each loop. For that we need a for each loop. I'm opening a PHP block. For each as errors as error. Error. Echo error. And I am going to add a break tag so that we can see it in a new lines. And we should add the styling with a bootstrap classes. I am going to do that later. First of all, let's see these errors here. Undefined variable errors. That's okay. We should add the PHP block for checking this errors array. If I submit, first name field is required, last name field is required, email. And we are seeing all these errors here instead of seeing errors here. And I want to do one more thing. I want to remove this array, post super global array. Just for now, let's keep it, and by end of this series, I am going to remove it. Don't forget to remove it in your projects. Otherwise, users will see this data. That's not required for them. It's for your purpose while you are developing. Just comment it out while putting it in a production server. I'm adding a if block. If is set and not empty, or we can check not empty directly. Not empty. Errors array. Okay. Let's indent it. Okay, here is a typo mistake, errors. Let's check all this. We have typos in all this. First name field is required, last name, email, gender, age. Everything is working correctly. What I'm going to do is I'm going to add a div for these errors in this if block. If the errors array is set, that is, if it's not empty, then only I am going to echo this styling, that is alert danger styling. I am adding a div opening tag class. alert, and we are using double quote marks outside, so I'm using single quote marks inside. Alert, alert, danger. And here I'm closing this statement with a semicolon, and we should close this div, opening div tag. And here I'm going to close this div tag entirely, closing div tag and a semicolon. Okay, let's reload this in browser and see. After submitting the form, we should see these errors. Now you can see these errors. I'm going to add a span tag. So I'm going to add a span tags for this and an icon with a glyph icon, Bootstrap's glyph icon. I'm using string concatenation here, span class glyph icon remove. I'm adding a NBSP. Now if I reload the form, you should see the icon. Here you can see this icon. Okay. Let's move this into panel body. Okay. Here you can see this error message inside this panel body. Previously it was in after this heading tag. Now I have moved this to panel body. These are the error messages. If I submit a field, we shouldn't see this error message. If I submit a value, we shouldn't see this error message. It's not displaying. Next task in this video is displaying success messages. In case if we don't have any errors, if I submit all the fields and if I don't have any errors, we should display a success message. For that, I am going to check error super global. In case if there are no errors, if empty errors, we'll proceed with our code, that is insert query or sending email to user, whatever it is, we'll proceed with after successfully sending that. And we are going to check if query, then only will display success message. Here we don't have any query or any email sending process. What I'm going to do is I'm going to directly send success message here, and I'm going to call it as messages array, or we can call it as a single array, or we can assign this to a variable instead of array. If we have multiple success messages in our code, we can use this message array, same like the errors array. Message no errors in the form, semicolon. And for displaying success messages, I am going to reuse the same code. It's the same, just we need to update the variables here. Here it's a message array, messages as messages. And here also it's a message, and instead of glyph icon remove, I am going to use okay. And instead of alert danger, it's alert success. Okay, let's load it in the browser with all the values. Submit, no errors in the form. Now you can see this is a success message, and the variation for displaying success and error messages is we have to assign this values to errors array or messages array. It's up to you whether you want to use variables or arrays. It's up to you, and you can display this message. That's it for displaying success and error messages. If you want to learn more about PHP forms, check out the videos in this series, PHP form series. And if you want to learn more about PHP with the projects, do check out my courses. All the links are provided in the description. If you like the video, do subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.